They both wanted uncomplicated, fast sex, and hooking up on the dating app Tinder was the perfect way to do it. But when Gable Tostee met Warriena Wright 2 years ago, their night of passion ended in death. A drunken argument, fighting, and then a sickening scream as Warriena fell 14 floors from Tostee's Gold Coast apartment balcony. That was horrific enough. But what drew further attention and condemnation was Tostee's unusual behaviour and apparent disregard for Warriena in the seconds and minutes after her death. Last month, Tostee was acquitted of murder after a jury heard an extraordinary piece of evidence, his own smartphone recording of what happened. Tonight, Gable Tostee speaks publicly for the first time. And we should point out the subject matter is confronting and some of the language explicit.
Hello, Dad. I might have a bit of a situation.
In the heart of surfer's paradise, a Tinder date has gone tragically wrong.
Like, I was all right at first and we, you know, had sex in bed, and then after that, like, she kept drinking.
In the early hours of August 8, 2014, Gable Tostee tells his father what has happened.
I think she thought it was like a joke or something, but she kept beating me up and whatever.
I will fucking destroy your jaw. It's not fucking funny.
Like, I forced her out on the balcony. And I think she might have jumped off.
...26-year-old New Zealander, Warriena Wright, has fallen 14 floors to her death.
I've been walking around and there's like a million cops around my building. I'm fucked. I don't know what to do.
Gable Tostee was right to be worried. Police would soon charge him with murder. For 2 years now, he has maintained his silence, refusing to be interviewed by police or take the stand during his sensational trial.
Mr. Tostee, is there anything you would like to say today?
But after walking free, he is now ready to tell his side of the story.
Tostee's a pig!
Any comments about all this media, all this attention? This is the final time you'll walk the street. You won't see us for a long time. You must have some sort of relief about that. Nothing at all.
Any comment at all that you'd like to make?
So when that jury came back and said not guilty, that must have been a huge relief for you.
Absolutely. It was... They took their time, but, you know, at the end of the day, they made the right decision.
Were you worried?
Well, it doesn't matter how innocent a person is. There's absolutely no comfort in being on trial for murder.
2 years ago, Gable Tostee was 28, addicted to fast cars, women, and bodybuilding. Surfer's paradise was his sexual paradise as well. When you met Warriena Wright, you were a bit of a playboy, weren't you?
I wouldn't say playboy. I mean, I like meeting girls. I like meeting girls, and
I noticed at one stage you boasted of sleeping with 180 different girls.
Wasn't intended to be a boast or anything. And those sorts of figures, you know, in this day and age, I'm not sure they're really that uncommon among a lot of guys.
What do you think? A lot of guys?
A lot of single guys. Yeah, it's not really a surprising figure.
1 in the morning on that night, you hit the record button on your phone. Why did you do that?
Well, the question isn't so much why did I do that, but why wouldn't you do that? Because I used to go out quite a lot drinking. I don't have the best memory when I drink. And in this day and age, hitting record is, recording your night out is as easy as pressing a button and leaving your phone in your pocket.
But what for?
It's more of a just in case thing, because you're better off having something and not needing it than needing something and not having it. And
just in case what?
Just in case, well, you know, the thing that happened on the 8th of August 2014 is a perfect example.
Let's go back to that night and have a listen to how the events unfolded. You happy to do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come here.
Have a good night.
I'm closed. Don't close the door. No. Do you want me to walk you back home or?
No, it's okay.
No, come on. No, don't be like that.
Just have a good night.
So everything's going okay at this stage? And you've offered...
At that stage, yeah.
You've offered to walk her back home?
Yeah, if she was going to go home, if that was what she wanted to do, I would have been all too happy to walk her back home.
So everything's going okay?
Yeah, I mean, at that stage, I noticed she was behaving a little bit quirky, and that's all I thought it was at first. And
that's your bag there, isn't it?
Yeah, but where's all her shit? Where's my fucking shit?
Like what?
At 1:35 a.m., things started getting heated. Warriena, clearly drunk, accuses Gable of stealing her phone.
No,
fucking... I will fucking destroy your jaw. It's not fucking funny.
Okay, she's pretty angry there.
Yeah.
Why is she so angry? She can't find her phone.
I'm not sure why she got so angry like that, but we were looking for her phone, apparently. And she couldn't find it, and she seemed to be blaming me for that, and I was offering to, you know, call her phone to help her find it. And,
Did you know where it was?
No, I didn't know where it was.
Okay, but at the time, you know, as we just heard, she says, do you want me to destroy your jaw?
Yeah.
So, had she already hit you?
At that stage, it was kind of what I understood to be play fighting, but as you'll see throughout the night, it got worse and worse.
What do I have to do?
Oh!
I think that was actually a rock being thrown at me.
You cop one there, did you?
Yeah, close range too.
It was after 2 a.m. that Warriena started pelting Gable with small decorative rocks that he had in his apartment.
But
I'm just Sam.
Oh! What?
But I'm just Sam, Deck!
All right, I'll power down.
Even at that point, I was trying to cooperate with whatever she had in her mind. I didn't know what else to do. I was just, I wanted it to stop.
Sounds like you've tackled her there.
I think we're just wrestling at the time.
That's really funny.
That's enough. That is more than enough. You've worn out your welcome.
At that point,
you've decided that's enough.
I've told her, you know, you've worn out your welcome, and there's a point where I kind of paused for a minute and thought, what do I do? You know, how do I sort this out? She can't be in my apartment any longer.
This is fucking bullshit.
It's at this point the 6'3" Gable becomes menacing, threatening Warriena with a choice of words the prosecution would later use to try to convict him.
You're lucky I haven't chucked you off my fucking balcony, you goddamn psycho little bitch.
Just a horribly, horribly unfortunate choice of words without having any idea what, you know, would happen next.
You're lucky I haven't thrown you off the balcony.
Yeah, and I didn't intend that as a threat. I intended it as a figure of speech to say you're lucky I've been so tolerant with you.
I know, but Gable, as it turned out.
I know how it looks. It's absolutely, you know...
It's a shocker.
It is the worst, you know, to even mention the balcony. It's the worst choice of words one could have used.
These are the forensic photos of Gable's flat. Rocks litter the carpet. A telescope lays on its side on the table. Meters away is the telescope clamp that Warriena grabbed and allegedly tried to use as a weapon.
This is where it all goes horribly wrong.
This is where I've basically bundled her up and started to carry her out the nearest door.
Murder! Murder!
Who the fuck do you think you are?
No!
Hmm?
No! No! No!
You're trying to kill me, huh?
No!
Why'd you try to hit me with that?
No!
Huh?
No!
We heard Warriena scream no 33 times.
No!
It's all on recording,
no! No!
It's all bad.
No! 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 No!
And she was begging to go home. Why didn't you just use the front door?
You mean after I disarmed her?
Whenever. You had multiple opportunities.
Well, the first thing I did was try to make her walk out the front door.
But you restrained her again?
After she took the clamp.
For the second time, you had control of her and you still chose not to use the front door. Why didn't you just use the front door?
Because that's only a question that you can ask in hindsight when you have to desperately get someone away from you and separate the two of you and try and de-escalate an altercation. It doesn't come into the equation that that person is going to climb off a balcony and fall 14 floors to their death.
But Gable, regardless, you had control of her. You're 6'3". She was 5'4". How far is it between the front door and the balcony door?
It was a lot closer to the balcony door, and it was wide open, and it was the logical option at the time.
No!
I would, but you've been...
No!
Oh,
no! No!
Just 27 seconds after Warriena Wright is locked out on the balcony, she falls to her death. The haunting final scream recorded on Gable's phone. Did you hear her scream?
I didn't hear it with my own ears, no. I only realised that there was a faint scream that my phone audio picked up.
But your phone recorded that scream.
Mm-hmm.
We can hear that scream.
Yeah.
Through the locked balcony door.
Yeah.
But you reckon you didn't hear it?
Not at the time, no.
Are you serious?
Yeah. No, all I saw was her on the other side of the rail for a fleeting moment, and then she was gone.
Coming up, why was Gable so quick to leave the scene?
I found a place that had some food.
You understand why many people would think you're a cold, heartless, cruel bastard. That's next on 60 Minutes.
Playboy accused balcony murderer. From tomorrow, the 28-year-old could be living at his parents' Gold Coast home if his bid for bail is successful.
push up.
For 2 years, Gable Tostee was out on bail, charged with the murder of Warriena Wright. Until his acquittal last month, the simple pleasures of a father and son game of golf seemed a world away.
Thanks very much for having a chat. I know this must be very difficult for both of you.
But his parents, Gray and Helene, never doubted Gable would clear his name and walk away a free man.
When your son was charged with murder, did that sound in any way believable?
Totally unbelievable and surreal. Didn't make any sense.
I was there when the police arrested Gable and put him in handcuffs and took him away, and I was totally concerned about that.
What, you just couldn't process what was happening?
Yes, it was hard to process. I didn't know why it was happening. To be called an accused murderer, my son, knowing the type of person that he is, caring and considerate and thoughtful of others, never harmed anyone else.
Yeah, it's the ultimate accusation, isn't it?
It is, absolutely.
So who's the real Gable Tostee?
Who am I really? Well, I'm a pretty normal kind of guy.
Would you say you're a kind person?
To the people I care about, yes. And to the causes I care about.
Kind and caring?
Well, I'd like to think so.
But it's his actions that night that would call both his innocence and character into serious question. When Warriena fell from that 14th floor balcony to her death, it was what Gable did next that really raised suspicions. He didn't call for an ambulance. He certainly didn't call the police. His first action was to call his lawyer. But with no answer, he decided to get dressed and leave the building.
Shit. Hi, the person you have called is not available.
Where the fuck are my keys?
So why didn't you go out on the balcony to check to see if she was okay?
Instinctively, I knew that if I ran out there and somebody saw me looking over the edge and she had actually fallen all the way, it would look like, it would not look good. It would look like I had forced her over or something.
So you were worried about what it would look like for you?
Of course I was worried about her. I was absolutely terrified at what had just happened to her, but you know,
you just told me that you were a kind and caring guy.
Yeah, absolutely. And
you couldn't even be bothered to go out on the balcony and look over the side and see what had happened to her.
Well, whatever had happened out there had happened, and looking over the edge, you know, that it doesn't help anybody. There's no purpose to it.
Wait, you kidding?
Well, no, I mean,
there's no purpose to looking over the edge. What, to see if she's alive? To see if she's okay?
No, because that's just, you know, knee-jerk curiosity. And like I said, I was deeply concerned by what had happened to her.
You were so deeply concerned, Gable, that from her death scream to the next event, which was you calling your lawyer, was 35 seconds.
I froze on the spot and I thought, I need to do whatever is the most rational thing to do at the moment. I need advice. By the time I ate, I had been wandering around the streets, confused, extremely drunk and in shock, and I needed to clear my head and sober up. And so I found a place that had some food.
Warriena Wright's body is on the pavement. You don't even know if she's still breathing, and you are happily munching away on a slice of Super Supreme.
There's nothing happy or casual or indulgent about it. That was that night, that was the most scared I've ever been. It's the most distraught I've ever been in my entire life.
Can you understand why many people would think you're a cold, heartless, cruel bastard?
When you put it that way, when that's all you say about a person with no insight or explanation, you know, the media can make people think what the media wants people to think.
For what happened that night, do you think there's any level of responsibility that Gable should take?
I don't think so. I mean, maybe in hindsight, he would have asked her to leave in the first 10 minutes. But that's in hindsight.
Helene?
I don't think so. I think that Gable behaved in a way that was appropriate.
But a week after the incident, Queensland police charged Gable Tostee with murder. They didn't allege Tostee threw her off the balcony. Rather, Warriena Wright was so afraid she fell to her death while trying to escape.
And do you think she was so frightened when you put her out in that balcony that that's why she attempted to climb down?
There was no threat to her. She was out there on her own. I was inside on my own. That's one of the most perplexing things to me. I can't understand what would drive a person to climb off a 14th floor balcony into nothingness.
She may have thought genuinely to herself that she just had to escape.
Again, I can't speculate. I didn't know what was running through her mind. And I didn't do anything to make her fear for her life.
Well, you'd restrained her, Gable. You'd thrown her out there. I mean, you can hear her breathing. It's choking.
You just don't understand. Let go. Certainly wasn't choking. I didn't choke her at any point. I didn't harm her physically at any point. That was proven in court by the pathologist. There were no signs of choking. There were no signs of any physical harm on her. Come on, get up. Get up. Fuck up. Get up. Okay, get up.
How did you have a restraint?
I can't remember exactly. I just used my size and whatever.
How? How did you use your size?
I can't remember. It wasn't choreographed or anything.
You honestly don't remember?
I don't remember exact hand positions or feet positions, no.
Would it surprise you to learn that I don't believe you?
Well, there are probably a lot of people who might not believe that, but the fact is that I don't remember those exact details.
Was there one particular thing that you thought this absolutely proves that he is innocent?
It all came back to the tape.
I will fucking destroy your jaw. It's not fucking funny.
Once you actually heard the tape in its entirety, we were confident that we would be able to satisfy the requirements, yes.
Fair to say everything hinged on the recording?
Oh, definitely, yes. Yeah, well, without it, it would be a completely different trial.
Gable Tostee's lawyer, Nick Dorr, was always confident the phone recording would acquit, not convict, his client.
Badam
Sam.
Oh! What?
Badam
Sam,
deck! Alright, I'll power down. Who's Sam?
So it was a double-edged sword. But having said that, I think it worked more in Mr. Tostee's favour than it did in the prosecution's favour, in the sense there was an accurate reflection as to what occurred that night. If you had actually heard someone give that description, or if Mr. Tostee had given evidence without that tape and explain what had occurred in that apartment for the hour and 46 minutes before.
Would have been unbelievable.
It would have been unbelievable.
Were you always confident that we'd get on?
After deliberating for 4 days, a Queensland jury cleared Gable Tostee of both murder and manslaughter 3 weeks ago.
The last couple of years for us, Mr. Tostee.
Tostee's a pig!
This sort of reaction from people, does that affect you at all, sir?
And so when the verdict came out, that must have been an incredible relief.
Yeah, it was.
Inexplicable. It was. It was just a relief in a way.
You're still feeling the stress now, aren't you?
Yeah, it's. It's difficult because it's relief to know that your son's not virtually going to die in front of your eyes, I suppose. It still didn't help Miss Wright's family. I mean, it's... They still are dealing with their loss. It just reduced the tragedy from one person to not being two people.
This was a very 21st century tragedy. A young couple hooked up by Tinder, and their night tracked by CCTV footage, captured by selfies, and recorded on a smartphone.
This is fucking bullshit. You're lucky I haven't chucked you off my fucking balcony, you goddamn psycho little bitch.
But the pain of a shocking and sudden death is as old as humanity itself.
I hate the fact that the last thing Warriena experienced was an argument, an altercation.
What would you do if you had your chance over again? What would you change?
Well, a lot of things I could have changed about that night.
Such as?
Taking her home earlier, in hindsight. But you don't get hindsight when you've never experienced something like this. In your entire life, you don't know what's going to happen. You don't expect these things, and you're not trained to deal with them in a certain way, especially not when you're on a Tinder date, a first date with someone. 'Cause I'm still feeling
lonely. We contacted Warriena Wright's family, but they didn't wish to make any comment about Gable Tostee. Hello, I'm Liam Bartlett. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.